I'd like to call this meeting to order. I'd like to welcome everyone tonight. The City Council meets the third Tuesday every month at 7:30. This is a special night. We have a lot of friends and family here. It's special for a lot of people for a lot of different reasons, so I thank all of you for coming. We work from a prepared agenda. If anybody doesn't have an agenda, it looks like all of them are gone. We did have some over there, but anyway, if anybody needs any more, then we'll pass some out if we need to. Any citizens would like to address the council, you may sign up to speak. The sheet was outside. If you have an opportunity to speak and you want to say anything to the council, we'll be glad to listen to you. I'd like to recognize a couple of people here. Eden Daily News, Katie Mann, raise your hand, Katie. Happy birthday tomorrow, Katie.
Thank you.
You didn't know I knew that, did you? Happy birthday. RCENO, Roy Sawyers. Roy, appreciate you coming as always. We have some dignitaries here. Mark Richardson, County Commissioner. Mark, can you raise your hand, please, just so they'll know who you are. And Keith Duncan, another County Commissioner. And we have a new City Councilman from Stone. We have Johnny Farmer here, our third dignitary. Item two, invocation, Lemuel Hardison, pastor of North Spray Christian Church, and that'll be followed by Pledge of Allegiance, Todd Harden, Fire Department. Stand for them.
Let us pray. Father God, as we come together here tonight, we do so thanking you for the blessings that's ours at this Christmas season. We thank you for the way that you have blessed our city this past year. We thank you for a new chapter that unfolds even tonight. Thank you for our new mayor, Wayne Tuggle, and the new council members. We pray, Lord, your blessings be upon them tonight and throughout the coming new year. Give them the wisdom, the inspiration that they need in making the decisions that come before us, so that in the end that the city of Eden will be a better place to live, to work, to worship, and to share with our families. Bless us and direct us even tonight. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
To
the flag of the United States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible,
with liberty and justice for all. Under item four, recognitions and proclamations, Morhead Memorial Hospital Foundation. Ed Holbrook, you will come forward, please.
Mr. Mayor, members of the City Council, excuse me. I'd like to ask Brad Corcoran if he could come down for a moment, please. For many of you who don't know, among all the myriad of other activities that Brad has, for the last 7 years, he has ably served as a member of our foundation board, one of its members. And we traditionally recognize our departing members in November, just before Thanksgiving, because that's National Philanthropy Month. But Brad had the best excuse. He was a concerned dad, and he had to be at his daughter's soccer match. So with that thought in mind and appreciating that priority, I said, well, Brad, if you can't come to me, I'm going to come to you. So tonight, what I'd like to present on behalf of Brenda Atkins, our chairman, and on the members of the foundation board, our thanks to you for the 7 years of active service that you gave. And I hope that you will display this collage of Morhead Hospital and some of the other historical buildings that represent healthcare here in Eden, North Carolina.
I appreciate it. Thank you, Ed.
Thank you, Brad.
Thank you.
Second point is NAACP, Malcolm Allen.
Angela, would you come around, please? First of all, I want to thank the city for this opportunity for to come here where we can show our appreciation and support for someone so deservingly. We'd like to show our appreciation for the years of service that Angela rendered to our organization and to recognize her latest accomplishment. We realize that you have to start somewhere, and Angela has made that start, so we're looking forward to the future. And I'd like to present her with this plaque right here, which says, "In appreciation for years of service rendered to our organization, Angela Hampton, and congratulations on your latest accomplishment as City Councilwoman, Eden, NAACP."
Item 5, resignation of Mayor Pro Tem Wayne Tugglin and declaration that Ward 6 City Council seat is vacant. Since being elected mayor, I would like to submit my resignation as Ward 6 Councilman effective immediately. With my resignation, I declare Ward 6 vacant, and I have given my resignation to the attorney.
I have it, and it'll be on file with the city clerk.
6, introduction of the Honorable EDWIN G. Wilson, Jr. Judge Wilson is the senior resident Superior Court Judge of District 78. Judge, could you come forward, please? All my grandchildren to come up here.
That's a lot of grandchildren.
5 of them. Come on over here. What y'all will do is hold the Bible. Will they come? Y'all hold the Bible right here.
Okay, will you put your left hand on the Bible and raise your right? Do you, Wayne R. Tuggle, Sr., solemnly swear or affirm that you will support the Constitution and laws of the United States and the Constitution and laws of North Carolina not inconsistent therewith, and that you will faithfully discharge the duties of your office as mayor of the city of Eden, so help you God?
I will.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much. B is the swearing-in of newly elected council member Jerry Epps, Ward 4. I'd like to declare Ward 4 vacant. Councilman-elect Jerry Epps, please come forward to be sworn in.
Do you, Jerry Epps, solemnly swear or affirm that you will support the Constitution and laws of the United States and the Constitution and laws of North Carolina not inconsistent therewith, and that you will faithfully discharge the duties of your office as city council member of the city of Eden, so help you God?
I will.
Congratulations.
Next is the swearing-in of newly elected Councilmember Darryl Carter, Ward 5. I'd like to declare Ward 5 vacant. Councilman Darryl Carter, please come forward to be sworn in.
Do you, Darryl Carter, solemnly swear or affirm that you will support the Constitution and laws of the United States and the Constitution and laws of North Carolina not inconsistent therewith, and that you will faithfully discharge the duties of your office as City Council member of the City of Eden, so help you God.
I will.
Congratulations.
I'd like to say one thing before I sit down, too. Take the opportunity to thank all the citizens of Eden for the confidence and re-elect me to a third term. And thank you.
Part D, swearing in the newly elected council member, Councilwoman Angela Hampton. This is Ward 3. I'd like to declare Ward 3 vacant. Councilwoman-elect Angela Hampton, please come forward to be sworn in.
You want somebody? Some people want to hold the Bible for you.
You'll put your left hand on the Bible and raise your right. Do you, Angela Hampton, solemnly swear or affirm that you will support the Constitution and laws of the United States and the Constitution and laws of North Carolina, not inconsistent therewith, and that you will faithfully discharge the duties of your office as City Council member of the City of Eden, so help you God?
I do.
Congratulations.
And I also would like to thank everyone for all that you've done to make this happen for me. I just thank all of Eden. Thank you.
Ms. Hampton, you are a new councilwoman, so you can come back and come up here and have your seat. Just out of curiosity, I think Sam Page showed up. Sam, appreciate you coming. Item 7, appointment filled an unexpired term as council member representing Ward 6. By assuming the position of mayor of vacancy is created in my ward, Ward 6. The City of Eden Charter, as well as the North Carolina General Statutes, obligates the City Council by majority vote to appoint a qualified person to fill the vacancy for the remainder of the unexpired term. I have a name I would like to submit to the council, and that name is Neville Hall. He is a qualified candidate in that he lives in Ward 6. He has a background in city government and that he presently serves on the ABC board and has been a member of the Partnership for Economic and Tourism Development for Rockingham County. I've known him since he was in the early grades of public school and watched him develop over the years. He is a good guy. He and his family have been an asset to this community for years to come. I like his positive attitude, his energy, and his vision. I think he will bring a little different perspective to the council because of his age and represent the city well. Do I have a motion to appoint Neville Hall to the vacated Ward 6 position?
I make a motion to appoint Neville Hall to the Ward 6 seat.
Is there a second?
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, no. Motion passes. Neville Hall. Accept this request to serve as City Council Ward 6, will you come down to be sworn in?
Do you, Neville Hall, solemnly swear or affirm that you will support the Constitution and laws of the United States and the Constitution and laws of North Carolina, not inconsistent therewith, and that you will faithfully discharge the duties of your office as City Council member of the City of Eden, so help you God?
I will.
Congratulations.
Neville, just sitting in my seat, there's a big shoes to fill, buddy.
Got some candy in this box.
Now, item 9. Council, is there a name to be nominated for Mayor Pro Tem?
Sir, I'd like to nominate Mr. Jim Burnett for Mayor Pro Tem.
Are there other names? I declare the nomination closed. Is there a motion to name Jim Burnett as Mayor Pro Tem?
Make a motion.
Have a motion. Is there a second?
Second.
We have a second. Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, no. Mr. Burnett, you're Mayor Pro Tem.
Thank you, Council.
Item 10, mayoral appointments. ABC Board Chairman Tommy Flint. ABC Board Tom Barber. Rockingham County Solid Waste Committee, Angela Hampton. Piedmont Triad Regional Council, Daryl Carter. Rockingham County Economic Development Partnership, Seth Woodall. Is there a motion to accept these appointments?
Make a motion that we accept the appointments as stated.
We have a motion. Is there a second?
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, no. Motion passes. Item 11, roll call. Let the record show that the council members, city manager, and the city attorney are present. Item 12, set the meeting agenda. Council members, just for your information, I would like to add 18F and G to the consent agenda. Does everybody have those?
Yes.
Should have gotten those left. Any additions or deletions to the agenda? Anyone? Is there a motion to set the agenda?
I make a motion to set the agenda.
Have a motion. Is there a second?
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, no. The agenda's set. Public hearing. I'd like to declare this public hearing open. A, consideration of a zoning text amendment request and adoption of an ordinance to amend section 11.24K5. To allow antique shops, consignment shops, used merchandise sales, bakers, and contractor offices are permitted uses in the business shopping center district. Request submitted by Jonathan Wise and the planning board. The request was amended by the planning board. This is zoning case Z-13-03. Ms. Stoltz.
Yes, sir. At last month's meeting, the city council had a lengthy discussion regarding amendments to the business shopping center zoning district. After that initial request was denied, another request was brought to the planning board, and at that time they asked that the report that's attached be submitted to you all. What it does is it does not add a definition for flea markets, nor does it expressly permit flea markets as a use in business shopping center. The planning board plans, should you all approve this request, to create a special use permit process to be brought back to this council to consider at a later date. Should that be adopted, then anyone interested in having a flea market would have to submit an application to the Board of Adjustment and meet all of the ordinance requirements and other considerations dependent on the site in order to be approved. I believe that these uses are quite conducive to adaptively reusing all of our shopping center properties. We have some empty big boxes and some other places that could be well served by creating foot traffic in these shopping center districts. Your staff and your planning board recommend in favor of this request.
Can you give us a bit of an overview of the special permit?
As yet, we've not...
That's what we requested and we talked about.
Yes, sir.
Because there's so much controversy with it. Just give us an overview of the special permit.
A special use permit is this. It is special permission to do something that the ordinance would not ordinarily allow you to do. To date, our city council has made the decision that all special use permits, with the exception of a PUD request, go to the Board of Adjustment. What happens there is that Your staff will sit down and we'll check with other jurisdictions to see what sorts of provisions they specifically require for all flea markets. We'll put those down, and then language will be inserted, as it is in all the other places that you can apply for a special use permit, that conditions can be added based upon the opinion of the zoning administrator, that's me, and the Board of Adjustment at the time of the hearing. Recently, the North Carolina General Assembly decided that special use permits no longer require a supermajority for your zoning officer to be overturned. At this point, it's a simple majority, which would mean 6 of the 10 would have to disagree with your administrator in order for it to be approved.
And Kelly, actually, this right here is just, this vote tonight is just a zoning text change, is all. It has nothing to do with the mall area, right?
Well, it will have to do with the mall and any other shopping center.
For the most part, this is just a zoning text change.
It is absolutely a zoning text amendment.
Okay. Any questions from council?
I have one. Did hear you define that, or you say that contractor equipment is not allowed.
Yes, sir.
Does contractor equipment include motorized construction and destruction vehicles?
Why, yes, it does.
I want to clarify that. Thank you.
Any other questions? Anyone want to speak in favor of this zoning text amendment? Is there anyone out there want to speak in favor? Is there anyone wants to speak in opposition to this? Is there anyone wants to speak in opposition? Since there's not any, I declare this public hearing closed. Is there a motion to adopt the zoning text amendment?
Make a motion that we do adopt the zoning text amendment with the clarification as stated by Ms. Stoltz.
Okay, is there a second?
Second.
Have a second? Any more discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, no. And the zoning text amendment passes. I'd like to declare this public hearing open. This is B, consideration of zoning text amendment request and adoption of an ordinance to amend section 11.24M1 of the zoning ordinance to allow mining and quarrying and asphalt paving production and sales as permitted uses in Industrial 2 zoning district. Request submitted by James Crossingham. Ms. Stoltz.
Yes, sir. There are times when I am surprised when someone comes in and makes a request to be allowed to do something on their property when our ordinance does not address it. That results from the way it is constructed and the fact that most of it has been in place since 1968. During the 24 years I've worked here, we've amended our ordinance a lot of times, but there are still things that come up that we believe need to be changed, and the council has often agreed. Industrial 2 is our least restrictive zoning district. It allows noisy, dirty, heavy industrial uses. It also allows everything that is allowed in Industrial 1. It's a pretty wide open district, and the intent of that is to take advantage of property that we have already decided in our land use plan is appropriate for heavy industrial uses. This request, again, is a text amendment. It's not site specific. It has nothing to do with a particular site. I will tell you that as your staff considered mining and quarrying, one thing we want to make perfectly clear is we think that should never be done on a site that's smaller than 75 acres in order to provide the extra buffering we have suggested in our text amendment request, and that no fracking be allowed. It is expressly put it in there, not including fracking. At this point, I don't know enough about fracking to make a recommendation to you all either way, whether we should consider it. I do know that we have a lot of the natural conditions that are in place in other jurisdictions and other parts of the country that fracking is occurring. So until this council is ready to address that issue, I strongly suggest that we specifically prohibit that, at least for now, perhaps forever. We believe that this is appropriate. One thing I was surprised, I2 allows concrete plants but not asphalt plants. There's not a lot of difference, in my opinion, to those. And I think it is in our best interest as a community to make this amendment.
Any questions from council?
Yes. in here, and I certainly agree with the, this, the restriction containing 75 or more acres, but you put in here the 50-foot forested buffer.
Yes, sir.
Which I think is good. Is that a for abutment, I think, to rivers and streams?
And residential properties.
And is that a standard, or is that...
That's much more restrictive than what our current buffering definition requires.
Right, but
it's the standard for a stream buffer.
Okay, that's what I mean.
But for land use type buffers, it is larger than we normally require.
Because I think that we need to make sure that every effort is made to keep anything out of the stream.
Absolutely.
And you mentioned that there are already some uses in these districts that would fall in the category. And I'm assuming from what I saw, that was the gasoline fuel, bulk terminals. That
yes, sir.
What you referred to there. Okay.
Any other questions for council? Anyone who will speak in favor of the zoning text amendment? Does anyone want to speak in favor of the zoning text amendment?
The gentleman that submitted the request is here, but I'm sure he's in the back. If you have a question, he can answer it, but otherwise, I think he and I are in agreement.
Anyone will speak in opposition to the zoning text amendment? Is there anyone who will speak in opposition to the zoning text amendment? If not, I declare the public hearing closed. Is there a motion to adopt the zoning text amendment?
Make a motion that we adopt the zoning text amendment to allow the asphalt paving and production and sales and mining and quarrying.
We have a motion. Is there a second?
Excluding fracking.
Thank you.
Is there a second?
Second.
With the exclusion.
Any other discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, no. Motion passes. Item 14, request petitions of city. Have we had any? Okay, no. 15, unfinished business, no. 16, new business. Ms. Stoltz. Come back up again.
Sorry.
Board and commission appointments.
Yes, sir.
Also, I noticed there was a name change correction made from the original ETJ appointment. Mm-hmm. And all council members get that change. The original sheet that she gave out, I think there was a name change on there.
Yes, we had Steve Underwood listed, who recently resigned, and he has been replaced. That person, okay. David Everett, would need to be reappointed.
Anybody have any appointments?
I do.
Okay, Mr. Burnett.
I'd like for the reappointment of Mr. Franklin Galloway to the Board of Adjustment, Mrs. Jean Harrington to the Historic Preservation Commission, and Mr. Giles Huntings to the Planning Board.
Mr. Carter.
I'd like to reappoint Kathy Carter to the Community Appearance Committee. And Tree Board, Max Kurtz. Okay. And Planning Board, I'm going to keep that up until next month until I talk to you.
Okay. Ms. Hampton?
I'd like to nominate Tamara Cable on the Planning Board to replace me.
Okay. Any other?
Step back for us.
Ms. Dales?
TAMYRACAPLE.
Thank you,
ma'am. Mr.
Ellis. We would like to reappoint Francis Craddock on the Board of Adjustment and Clay Shelton, Community Appearance Commission.
Community Appearance for Ward 1, Historic Preservation, Phyllis Stickles.
Okay.
Has agreed to serve again. That's the only one I have right now.
Anyone else? Is there a motion to accept these appointments?
I make a motion we accept these appointments.
We have a motion. Is there a second?
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, no. Appointments are accepted. Motion passes. 17, reports from staff. And the last thing on the agenda, consent agenda. Is there a motion to accept the consent agenda?
I make a motion we accept the consent agenda.
Is there a second?
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, no. Consent agenda is passed. 19 announcements. Are there any announcements? Not that I'm aware of. And 20, is there a motion to adjourn?
I make a motion to adjourn.
We have a motion. Is there a second?
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, no. And we are adjourned. We appreciate everybody coming. Thank you.